responses largely has to hear out prayer. For Christians around the world who are suffering from persecution, that they may be kept safe from harm, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear out our prayer.
That peace may be proclaimed in our country, both within and without, as we celebrate the anniversary of our independence, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear out our prayer.
That prosperity of our country may reach the poorest among us, so that the burden of poverty may be lightened for all, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear out our prayer.
For those suffering from drug addiction, and for their families and loved ones, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear out our prayer.
For all of us, that we may come to the assistance of others in need, helping to make their yoke easy and their burden light, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear out our prayer. Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Vicki McFarland and our mass attention, that they may enjoy the fullness of Christ's resurrection, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer.
For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our heart, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, we pray.
Lord, we ask you to hear our prayer. Our King and our God, you are gracious and merciful, good to all and compassionate toward all you have created. We ask you to listen to our prayers this day. We make and lighten our burdens through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours will be accepted by God, our Almighty Father. This offering dedicated to your name, purify us, Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the light of heaven. We pray this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to raise to you a hymn of glory and praise, O Lord, Father of infinite goodness. For by the word of your Son's gospel you have brought together in one church from every people, tongue, and nation. And having filled her with life by the power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. Manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom and shines bright as the sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus our Lord you promised would last forever. And so with all the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, while with all the church as one voice we acclaim. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks. Giving the cup to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Counted down until the day. day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lord, renew your church. In the Poconos, by the light of the gospel, strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, that together with Francis our Pope, Joseph our Bishop, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us when our earthly pilgrimage is done, we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Vincent de Paul, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now let us pray. Words that our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Keep us always free from harm, protect us from anxiety, distress, and sin, and whatever may lead us to sin, so that we may wait as a joyful people in hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us share some sign of the Lord's peace with each other. Behold Jesus Christ, behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. pray. By showing us in this Eucharist, Lord, a glimpse of the unity and joy of your people in heaven, deepen our unity and intensify our joy, that all who believe in you may work together to build a city of lasting peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. For Holy Communion, I would ask you to come up the middle aisle, and the way it's going to work, people on this side will turn and go down that side aisle and out the door, and the people on this side will go down and go down that side aisle and go out the door. I think that's the way it's going to work. No, you know what? I'll be here. I will be in the center. Okay. And we'll work with that. Any questions? Also, we ask you not to congregate at the Mass outside, and we ask you to have a good day, good evening, and the rest of the weekend. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May God the Father, who has called us to be one human family, fill our hearts with deep longing for peace and harmony. Amen. May the Son of God, who came to share our life and make us children of the one Father, enable us to grow in wisdom and grace before God and the human family. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, who is the bond of love between the Father and the Son, unite and love all of us, and may he be the bond of love among us, our nation, and all peoples. Amen. May Almighty God bless and keep us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go as God's people in peace to love and serve him and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, and have